Hi, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In the previous video, we learnt about the motor effect. By the end of this video, you should be able to understand what's meant by induced potential and the generator effect. After you watch this video, you should be able to describe all things that affect the size and direction of the induced potential. Let's start. Here we can see wire near magnetic field. If we move the wire through the magnetic field like this, then a potential difference is induced across the ends of the wire. But when the wire stops moving, then the potential difference is lost. If we move the wire back up through the magnetic field, then we get the potential difference again. We can notice that the potential difference is now in the reverse direction. This potential difference effect is called induced potential. If we have complete circuit, then in this circuit, we induce a current. This effect is called the generator effect. Like in the wire example, the direction of the current changes when the direction of movement changes, and if the movement of the circuit stops, then the current also stops. Also, we can get induced potential and an induced current if our circuit is stationary, but we move our magnetic field, like shown. One thing that we must remember is that the generator effect will occur only if the wire or circuit passes through the magnetic field. If the wire or circuit moves along the magnetic field, like shown, then we do not get an induced potential difference or current. The size of the induced potential difference or induced current depends on three factors. Induced potential difference or induced current is larger if we use stronger magnetic field. If we move the wire or circuit more frequently. If we shape our wire or circuit in the form of the coil. More turns of the coil, greater induced potential and current in the wire or circuit. In this example, you can see how the magnet moves in and out from the coil of a wire. As you can see, this also produces an induced current. As we have seen in past examples, the direction of the current changes when the direction of movement of the magnet changes. Remember that we can also change direction of the induced current if we switch poles of the magnet, like shown. We have to go through one more thing, and this thing is quite tricky. As we have seen, when we move a magnet into a coil of wire, a current is induced in the wire. As we already know, induced current creates its own magnetic field, and this magnetic field opposes the movement of the magnet. Let me explain this. When we insert the north pole into the coil, that end of the coil also becomes a north pole. This repels the magnet, as we know from the magnetism, the same poles are repelled, making it harder to push the magnet in the coil. When we pull out the magnet from the coil, the end of the coil becomes the south pole. This attracts the magnet. As we know from magnetism, opposite poles attract each other, making it harder to pull it out. Because the induced current makes it harder to move the magnet, this actually means we are making work. We're transferring energy from the movement of the magnet into the movement of the current. If we go back to our diagram, we can see that if we move the wire through the magnetic field like this, then a potential difference is induced across the ends of the wire. How can we determine the direction of induced current? To determine the direction of induced current, we can use Fleming's right-hand rule. How can we use Fleming's right-hand rule? First, place your thumb, first finger and second finger in such a way that they are mutually perpendicular to each other. We have to apply right hand in such a way that your thumb points in the direction of the motion of the wire. Your forefinger points in the direction of the magnetic field. Then the second finger gives you the direction of induced current. So, with Fleming's right hand rule, we can determine the direction of induced current. Shown in this example, second finger points direction of the current and thumb points direction of the movement of the wire. Also, you can see how direction of induced current changes when we change the movement of the wire. If you like, you can pause the video and try to use Fleming's right hand rule. If anyone would ask you someday to describe electromagnetic induction, there's no better way than with Faraday's law of induction. Faraday's law of induction is a basic law of electromagnetism that predicts how a magnetic field will interact with an electric circuit to produce an electromotive force, EMF. The equation for the EMF induced by a change in magnetic flux is, where EMF is electromotive force in volts, N is number of turns of coil, Fi is magnetic flux in Weber, and T is time in seconds. So, right now we can conclude that three parameters affect the size of electromotive force. EMF is proportional to magnetic flux density and the number of turns of the coil, and EMF is inversely proportional to time. EMF is greatest when the change in time, t, is smallest. I hope that you now know what is the generator effect. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share this video. Watch the rest of my videos from my YouTube channel. Please consider to support me on Patreon. Thanks very much. See you on the next video.